I am literally spoiling everything about the Star Wars sequel trilogy, so if you could please, so if you don't want to be spoiled, I recommend you leave. Thank you. Hello and welcome to a review. I'm trying to be a little cooler with this. I made a script and all that, so I wanna do a calm down review. So yeah, basically, the Star Wars sequels, they are a mess. They are no good, and I'm about to give my reasoning why. Again, I already said if you do not want to be spoiled for any of these movies, I'll be only talking about Force Awakens, The Last Jedi, and The Rise of Skywalker again. I won't be talking about the other, the Han Solo and the other one, whatever it's called. It's not Rogue One, yeah, I'm not talking about those. I'm just talking about the main three. And yeah, I'm really excited to do this, if I'm gonna be honest. And yeah. The Star Wars sequel trilogy. It's a dangerous topic, and I am terrified to even start talking about it, but I have become a more independent man. I have recently learned how to walk, speak, spell, and even wipe my own ass, so I feel like this should be the next step in my career. Once again, everything here is an opinion and not a fact. Yeah, thank you. Let's get going. So, the first one we're gonna start off with is The Force Awakens, and this one is the least divisive one, since most people actually enjoy this movie. It introduces us to Rey, Finn, and Poe, and still to this day, I believe these characters have almost been perfect. This movie reminded us of how fun Star Wars can be after the dumpster fire that were the prequels. It's a breath of fresh air, and I loved it. This is in no way the same as New Hope, and I stand by that, and I always stand by it. If you ignore the tone of these movies, then yes, sure, they are the same. But you shouldn't do that, that's not how it works. Anyway, that's a topic for another day. Alright, anyways, I'm gonna casually just drop a bombshell. I'm not scared to say it, but you know what, who am I kidding? I'm actually kind of scared to say it. But I actually like Rey. Now listen up, listen up. I don't care how she's too strong or a Mary Sue. It's a space adventure sci-fi film. Calm down. I don't know, man. It feels like nitpicking if I'm being honest. Star Wars characters are good at stuff. Why you ask? Because it's a goddamn movie. I don't know if I'm missing something here, but I don't see a problem with Rey. And now, with that, we're gonna move on to a character who I thought was even better in this movie than the main one, which is Rey. Finn. Finn is amazing. Finn is so good. Dare I say, perfect in this movie. I'm not even gonna drag on this talk for too long, but a stormtrooper running away is such a good storyline, and I would love to see a movie all about that. At first, he is selfish, only using Poe to lead, but then the best romance ever starts, and when he starts caring for him quickly, since he never could care for anyone, goes from selfish to finding something worth fighting for, and it's beautiful. Now, let's talk about maybe the best thing in this trilogy. Let's talk about Kylo Ren. I doubt anyone will be really mad or offended when I say the following: that he's probably, if maybe not 100%, the best thing in this trilogy. And I mean it. I really don't see why people would dislike him. We never saw something along the lines of a Jedi slowly being dragged to the dark side and a Sith slowly being dragged to the light side. And honestly, this is a really good idea, and it should have been a no-brainer if I'm honest. I think he might be one of the best villains ever on the big screen of Star Wars. It's quite easy to make a really bad villain in movies, but they really did get it right. We have seen so many villains in the Star Wars just be evil for absolutely no reason, but if they need a good villain, let me rephrase that. A villain. And it has actually driven me to madness. The The script is alright, and the acting is quite good, if not even impressive. Now, the jokes, I don't really laugh at movies, and this one was no different. The jokes can really get annoying, and in some scenes, throw out all the tension out the window. Now, overall, at face value, I enjoy this movie, and with that in mind, I think it's time to grade it. Now, I don't like giving it an 8.5 rate, I actually hate that, but it is in between 9 and 8. So, it's an 8.5 out of 10. Alright, okay. This is not an apology video, but someone should, and it's probably the maker of this upcoming film, The Last Jedi. I think this is an average movie, or maybe just slightly under average. Numero one, that made zero sense, let's pretend like I've never said that. You know Finn, who I said had a shot to be one of the best characters in Star Wars, maybe even ever. Well, this movie just flipped us off heavily, if I'm gonna be totally honest with you. Finn has been degraded, ruined, and I hated how they treated him. It should have never been Rose and him on a mission. And Rose was bad. Once again, it could have all been fixed, simply with just there being Poe and Finn. It would have made everything so much easier, and honestly, just a better story overall. Now, I'm gonna go on to another tricky topic, Luke Skywalker. Luke Skywalker in this movie wasn't treated nicely, but nonetheless, I think by the end, I like how they ended his story. I felt happy. It felt good is what I'm trying to say. I didn't really type in much here. I don't know, man. I feel like, again, another talk about how they treated him here should be its own thing. It's huge, and I feel like I just didn't want to waste too much time on it, because I am actually thinking of making a video just on the topic of Luke and how he's been treated in the sequels. In the sequel, one of them. But again, like I said, I actually really enjoyed the way he just went out and passed away. I really liked that. Now, I hate the Finn, Poe, and Rose missions. I just can't handle them. Whenever it went from Rey and Luke to the Finn and the other gang, I just turned my brain off. Then when we went back to Rey and Luke, I was ready to activate my brain once again. So, yeah. Another thing. I don't want to buckle up just to spit some hot takes and videos. But it's time to put your straps on, because I'm gonna drop a huge, huge, huge bombshell. Rey being a nobody is actually amazing. Yep, I've said it, and I don't think.
Did you come back to say you forgive me?
I feel like someone's immediately
acting. Save my soul.
Auto clicker on the dislike button.
No.
Which makes no sense, because that was a really bad joke, because auto clicker won't really help you if you dislike once, you can't dislike more times. I mean, you can on other accounts, but I just see that as honestly really, really stupid. Now, okay, it's okay to want a huge reveal, and I understand that, to want to reveal that Rey is maybe a Skywalker, or a Kenobi. I honestly expected that as well. Did I want it? A little. Yes, maybe I did. But nonetheless, it is what it is. But this made way more sense than her being a Palpatine, which again, I will get to later. Now, you probably know that this guy probably inspired me to do reviews more than any other channel. Cosmonaut from the Cosmonaut Variety Hour said it best here. I watched a clip.
I should also say that I hate when people use the kill the past line in order to criticize this movie. I really don't get why people think this is one of the themes of the movie. Because the villain is the one who says this. You know, the guy who's wrong, we're supposed to take what he says and disagree with it. That's what the movie wants from you.
Now again, something Marcus slash the Cosmonaut Variety Hour says in the following footage, I didn't see, that people, Star Wars fans who don't like this movie, like to use the line said by Kylo Ren, kill the past. He's basically the director pointing a full-on missile at Star Wars and just telling you and just flipping you off at the same time. Now what is Kylo? I'm gonna give you 20 seconds to think about it. Time's up. A villain. Do we agree with villains? I'm gonna give you another 30 seconds to think about this one. No, we don't. And that is the point. We don't agree with him. So why should we agree with the kill the past line? Basically what the angry Star Wars fans are referring to is basically kill the original trilogy, I believe. If they're trying to say the good one. And this movie really, really made a lot of people angry, and honestly, for a second, even I thought that was the director pointing a full-on missile at Star Wars. So, you know, I can't blame them too much. Now, this movie does a lot. Wait, let me rephrase that. Tries a lot. But it never really succeeds. Now, you probably want me to talk about Kento Bund, but I actually thought that was a good scene. Almost as good as my ability to lie. Kenno Bight is trash, useless, pointless, and every time you say its name, you lose 8 to 9 brain cells. It really depends. Kenno Bight is like Voldemort. We don't say his name. Now, pacing is a real issue. It's a really, really, really big issue in the sequel trilogy. And I don't think they got it here, right here either. I think they got it very well in the Force Awakens. Here, they messed it up. It's like singing one syllable off, is what I'm trying to say. If you watched my The Rise of Skywalker review, then you know I dislike a movie when it has bad pacing and is boring. This one, the pacing is slightly bad, like I said, singing with one syllable off. But this movie, again, it's not boring, but it tries too hard not to be. There's a lot of confusing action. And it just isn't choreographed well, in any way, shape, or form. Now, the prequels sucked, in almost every way, shape, or form. But choreography was a huge part of it. It made the battles much more fun and engaging. It was probably the best part in them. Now, if I'm gonna be fun real with you, basically the fight scene in this one is like, in this one we get like one, two evil. You know what? Imagine like people at an office going like, all right, so we're gonna have this guy be. So it's here. It's a 2v1. It's two of these guys against Rey, and then one guy waits till one guy dies, and when he dies, the other one is like, all right, now I'm popping in. What were they thinking? I genuinely don't know. I'm genuinely confused how they even thought that this was gonna be a good idea. So, basically, I know I didn't really say too many good things about this movie, but what I did like is the following. I liked Rey and Kylo a lot in this movie, and this movie was probably the best after Snoke was killed. Alright, my brain cells are dropping like flies in here, so I'm just gonna rate it quickly, and if I'm gonna be honest, it's a 7 out of 10. It might be a controversial opinion. I don't know. It is probably a very controversial opinion. Okay, you can do it. Alright, it's time to talk about The Rise of Skywalker. And I know, I reviewed it, but now I have a bit more to say. I rewatched it and all that jazz, I read up more. So yeah. This movie, when I really rewatched it and I really looked at the tone, it felt frustrated, angry, and just annoyed at something. And it's the first time a movie actually challenged me since I didn't understand it completely. I didn't understand what happened. This movie this movie's pacing. You can say it's like if I was in a marathon walking and out of nowhere started running at lightning speed, tripped, walked again, and then again lightning speed, and it just kept repeating that till the marathon was finished, which I guess was like a around 2 hours long marathon. Now this movie takes so many left and right turns, it's actually crazy. I stand by what I said, that the pacing is dog wank, and that the entertainment I get from this watching this film is probably challenged by watching paint dry. But now, guess what? I hate more stuff. Great. No, legit. I hated this movie a lot more when I rewatched it. The jokes are still 50-50, they're mainly hit and miss, and the acting has gotten slightly better. But oh my god, I rewatched and paid attention to the script and realized how garbage it was. I could open up Word, throw my keyboard through the window, bring it back up the stairs, and the script would be a little more meaning. Actually, no. Be way better. The lines they gave the actors are just awful. I genuinely felt bad for them at one point. I also totally am disgusted at the title crawl. I don't think I said this back then, and I don't think I understood how big of a deal this was back then either. But too much stuff off screen, and I'm out. I'm gone. Oh wow, Palpatine is back. How? Oh wait, yes, Fortnite. No, legit, to understand something in a movie, in a Star Wars movie, you need to watch a live Fortnite event. Or watch like a video, live stream, whatever. I was there during the event and I realized no one older than 15 in that theater had any idea who Palpatine, how Palpatine is back, and even I was confused. The dead speak. Maybe even more lifeless than the game itself. And again, the CGI was good, and the music was good, but to end it all, the long talk about Rey being a Palpatine. I said I would do this, I said I would make a separate video. I can't be bothered to make a full-on video, but I feel like I'm gonna focus on this a bit more now. It's gonna be quite long, so buckle up. Reddit. Was it worth it? This annoyed me so many times, mainly since I didn't mind Rey being a no one. She didn't need to be important, that's cool, but then they went ahead and ruined it all, and you know that wouldn't have happened if people didn't care. This only happened because the Star Wars fans, which I don't even think they're fans at this point, have been like, that's not good, I don't like that. So they backtracked and were like, you know, her parents aren't important, but her grandparents, on the other hand. They went ahead and just ruined it all. And the way we found out the fact that Rey was a Palpatine was the most basic, mundane way. And if you were watching it, you wouldn't. Now listen up. You could walk into a theater knowing nothing about Star Wars, and you know that the fact that that Darth Vader is Luke's father is a big deal, because it's in the final half, and the emotional pull is huge, and also probably, I don't know what it was back then, but the reaction of the crowd must have really gave something off. But in this one, no one in the crowd, at least in the theater that I was, reacted. No one. So I was like, is this a big deal? Should I be confused? Should I react? What should I do? Should I clap? Should I go wow or something? I don't know. I genuinely was not too sure. Now the way that we found this was basically Kylo going, LOL, yeah, by the way, you're Palpatine's granddaughter, so you know, we should like hang out sometime. Okay, not exactly like that, but you get the point. Was a reveal in the middle of the movie, while the I am your father twist was in the last third of the film, making it more impactful. By the way, not this film, obviously, you probably knew that. But it is what it is. The movie also focuses on Rey just slightly too much, where I would have liked to see Finn, maybe Poe, I don't know, get some more love after the first chunk of the movie. after the Palpatine twist, I genuinely just said to myself, you know what? Cool, keep going. Disney hurt me plenty because I'm strapped in. And I really, really, really wanted this to be a good ending to the Skywalker saga. I didn't care too much. But when after I realized how bad it was, that's when I cared more. And I don't even know how I feel about this movie. All I wanted was this to be at least a solid, good movie. It's sad. It's unfortunate. It's not. So basically, if you watch my other review, it went, I honestly think, from a 6 out of 10 review in my first review, it's now gone to a 5.5 out of 10. It's a slight change, and again, I hate 0.5 reviews, but I'm gonna have to be honest, that's really what they deserve here. But what really scares me here is, where do we go now? Star Wars ended on a whimper, not a bang, as many people expected. So is this gonna be it? I hope not, because I still enjoy these movies and I want to see more. But I wouldn't be surprised if Star Wars is long gone and that's gonna basically be it. The fan base, everything is quite quiet ATM at the moment. And I really don't know what to say. I hope for the best for the whole Disney team and crew. And yeah. I love these movies and I genuinely care. I wouldn't be surprised if it is. But nonetheless, thank you for watching. And goodbye.